he said, have you got a record deal? I said, no. And he said, do you want one? And I said, who really? He said, Crazy. And I went, yeah.
Let's just do that.
That was it.
The gentleman on the left with the strange hairstyle is Alan McGee, the Chief Executive Officer of Creation Records.
The relationship between Alan and Bobby was fundamental.
My God, maybe I can do that. And that was it. That was the moment that Creation Records became a reality and I decided to do that.
Random collection of misfits, drug addicts and sociopaths.
But they just need to stay up.
A little grateful people's sleeves and stuff in your hands and, you know, I'm not going to do this. There's got to be more to it than this.
Even though it was mania, we had no idea that the world was going to go up.
It was just drinking far too much, and I didn't find it very easy coping with being famous all of a sudden.
We were just being really angry, and full of energy and spirit, and all that was a bit less fun.
And it eventually became the mainstream sound of a generation.
Billy Nebworth was above and beyond any of my expectations.
Kind of went from being a kind of proper Indian label to almost like a parent from kind of multinational second out in a club. I need Bob's name. Didn't have anything to say. Which was a fuss.
So really, you know, the Creation Records story is, I guess it's about the death, the end of the independent thing.